स्वेच्छाकेसरिणः स्वच्छस्वच्छाय आयासित इन्दवः त्रायन्तां भूमद्रिपोः प्रपन्नार्थे छिदो नकाः. So we looked at Asamlakshekrama Vyangya divisions and how Rasadhvani, how should Alankaras be used in Rasadhvani. After that chapter, he moved on to Samlakshekrama Vyangya. So Vivakshita Anya Paravachya is divided into Samlakshya and Asamlakshekrama Dhvani. In that, Asya Kramena Pratibhati Atma Yo Asya Anuswana Sannibaha Shabdartha Shakti Moolatvatu So Api Dvedha Vyavasthitaha Saha Api द्वेधा व्यवस्थितः सः इस् संलक्ष्यक्रमव्यङ्ग्यः. द फस्ट् लैन् अस्य इस् विवक्षित अन्यपरवाच्यध्वनि. सो अस्य विवक्षित अन्यपरवाच्यध्वनेः अनुस्वानसन्निभः यः प्रतिभाति, यः अनुस्वानसन्निभः आत्मा, यः आत्मा प्रतिभाति अनुरणनप्रख्यः संलक्ष्यक्रमव्यङ्ग्यत्वात् अनुरणनप्रख्यः. ऐ टोल्ड् लास्ट् ड्यूरिङ्ग् द लास्ट् क्लास् आल्सो, अनुरणनं मीन्स् इट् इस् लैक् एन् एक्को. यु फस्ट् हियर् वन् सौण्ड् एण्ड् देन् द नेक्स्ट् सौण्ड् फालोस्. दट् इस् वाट् इस् एन् एक्को. बोत् एन् एक्को एण्ड् इट्स् ओरिजिनल् सौण्ड् विल् नाट् अपियर् एट् द सेम् टैम्. सो अनुरणनं, अनु पश्चात् आगच्छति इति अनुरणनप्रख्यः और् अनुस्वान, बोत् आर् द सेम् मीनिङ्ग्. यः आत्मा इति व्यवस्थितः, दिस् केन् आल्सो संलक्ष्यक्रमव्यङ्ग्य इस् आल्सो अ ध्वनि वेरैटि एण्ड् दट् ध्वनि इस् आल्सो एन् आत्मा आफ् काव्यं. सो अपि शब्दशक्ति उद्भवः यः आत्मा सो अपि शब्दशक्तिमूलः अर्थशक्तिमूलः च इति द्विप्रकारः व्यवस्थितः. इट् इस् डिवैडेड् इन् टु टु, वेर् इट् केन् बि बै द पवर् आफ् वर्ड्स् और् बै द पवर् आफ् द मीनिङ्ग्. ऐदर् वाचकशब्द केन् बि केन् काण्ट्रिब्यूट् टु द ध्वनि आर् द वाच्यार्थ केन् काण्ट्रिब्यूट् टु द ध्वनि. ननु शब्दशक्त्या यत्र अर्थान्तरं प्रकाशते स यदि ध्वनेः प्रकारः उच्यते तदिदानीं श्लेषस्य विषयः एव अपहृतः स्यात् न अपहृतः इत्याह आक्षिप्त एव अलङ्कारः शब्दशक्त्या प्रकाशते यस्मिन् अनुक्तः शब्दशक्त्या शक्ति उद्भवः हि सः. यस्मिन् अनुक्तः शब्देन शब्दशक्ति उद्भवः हि सः. पूर्वपक्षी आस्क्स् अ क्वश्चन् वेर् शब्दशक्त्या यत्र अर्थान्तरं प्रकाशते, इफ् देर् इस् अनदर् मीनिङ्ग् विच् इस् सीन् बिकास् आफ् द फोर्स् आफ् द वर्ड्स् आर् द पवर् आफ् द वर्ड्स्, सः यदि ध्वनेः प्रकारः उच्यते, इफ् वि से दट् इट् इस् ए क्लासिफिकेशन् आफ् ध्वनि, देन् वाट् इस् द स्कोप्, वाट् इस् द डोमेन् आफ् श्लेष, दट् इस् इन् क्वश्चन् हियर्. सो तदिदानीं श्लेषस्य विषयः एव अपहृतः, देर् इस् नो स्कोप् फार् श्लेष अट् आल्. If you say that all of those arthantaram yatra 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 sarvatra arthantaram prakashate tatra shabda shakti utbavah dvanehe eva vishayah iti yadi vadamaha tarhi sleshasya vishayah eva namavati. For that the Siddhanti says no, there is a difference between that. When the arthantaram is vachyam, if it is akshiptam it is shabda shakti, if it is vachyam it is slesha. That is the difference. Akshipta eva alankaraha shabdashaktiya prakashate yasmin anuktaha shabdena shabdashakti udbhavaha hi saha. If it is not said by a word in the shloka and you only and the alankara is only suggested, then it is shabdashakti udbhavaha dhvani. If a word in the shloka itself gives us the alankara along with slesha, then it is slesha and that alankara, that's all. It is a vachyam, there is no dhvani there. Either you can say samsrishti or sankaram or whatever combination of alankaras can be, you can highlight that one, but it is not dhvani. So yasmat alankaraha na vastu matram यस्मिन् काव्ये शब्दशक्त्या प्रकाशते, यस्मिन् काव्ये शब्दशक्त्या अलङ्कारः प्रकाशते न तु वस्तुमात्रम्. यु डु नाट् हेव् वस्तुना वस्तुध्वनि हियर्, इट् इस् ओन्ली प्रेसेण्ट् इन् काव्यप्रकाशं. सो डोण्ट् कन्फ्यूस् बिट्वीन् आनन्दवर्धन एण्ड् मम्मट हियर्. आनन्दवर्धनस् मतम् इस् ओन्ली वस्तुना अलङ्कारध्वनिरेव शब्दशक्ति उद्भवः. यू के नाट् हेव् वस्तुना वस्तुध्वनि. ओके, सो यस्मात् कारणात् अलङ्कारः प्रकाशते न वस्तुमात्रं यस्मिन् काव्ये शब्दशक्त्या सः शब्दशक्ति उद्भवः इति अस्माकं विवक्षितं. दट् इस् वाट् ऐ हेव् एक्सेप्टेड्. शब्देन अनुक्तः, शब्देन अनुक्तः मीन्स् वाचकशब्देन वाच्यम्, अलङ्कारः न वाच्यः. एण्ड् आक्षिप्तः एव, फोर् देट् आक्षिप्त ही इस् गोयिङ्ग् टु टाक् गिव् एक्साम्पल्स् लेटर् आल्सो. सो हियर् वस्तुद्वये च शब्दशक्त्या प्रकाशमाने श्लेषः यथा. नौ ही इस् गिविङ्ग् अस् द डोमेन् आफ् श्लेष. वाट् पूर्वपक्षीस् क्वश्चन् इस् if every shloka where an arthantara is suggested through the power of words is considered as shabda shakti udbhava, then what is the scope of shlesha? Now the next couple of shlokas are going to be the domain of shlesha and not shabda shakti udbhava, so keep that clear. He is going to give us only shlesha udaharanam for the next few, and this is just purely shlesha. The next few shlokas are all examples of shlesha with another alankara like virodabhasa or vyatirekam or upama, rupakam, etc. Okay? So, vastu dvayecha shabda shaktya prakashamane shleshaha eva. When we saw vastuna vastudvani, right? Here, when two vastu, vastu means two ideas are seen through the power of words, shabda shaktya using the abhida ashakti, if two meanings are seen from a shloka, then there is only shlesha alankara, it is not shabda shakti. So the example for that is yena dvasta manobhavena balijit kayav purastri kritaha yashchodvritta bhujangahara valayo gangamcha yo dharayat yo adharayat yasyahu shashimat chiroharayit stutyam cha nama amaraha payat sa swayam andhaka kshayakaraha Tvam sarvado madavaha. Here the word sarvado madavaha is split, can be split as sarvadaha madhavaha or sarvada umadhavaha. The sandhi lends in different ways where we can split it into two different manner, and so one meaning would be for Vishnu and the other meaning would be for Shiva. We saw the shloka in Kavya Prakasham 7th Ullasa also, but I'll anyway give the meaning here. So sarvadaha madavaha tvam payat, let Vishnu protect you. Now how is this Vishnu? Everything else is now as an adjective, visheshanam for Vishnu. Madhavaha mayaha dhavaha, ma iti lakshmihi, lakshmiyaha dhavaha patihi, madhavaha Vishnuhu. Saha sarvadaha, sarvam dadati iti sarvadaha. He is a giver of everything. Whatever you ask for, he is a giver of boons. Tadrishaha Vishnuhu tvam payat tvam rakshatu. Let him protect you. How is he? Yena anaha dvastam. Dvastam anobhavena. You split it as dvastam anaha abhavena. That is another adjective. So, yena abhavena anaha dvastam. Yena pura, yena abhavena anaha dvastam, yena cha pura balijit kayaha stri kritaha. This is how you are going to split for Vishnu. So the one who had destroyed Shakatasura, anaha is chakram, is a part of the chakram. So one who had destroyed the shakata balakridayam anaha shakatam. Shakatam is a cart. So the one asura who was sent by Kamsa came in the form of a shakatam or a cart. So Krishna balakridaya kridayam, in during the when he was playing, he was a very small baby. The first one was Putana when he was just a stanandayaha. Then all of them were in the Yamuna Theeram and they had just put him under a cart for shade. So that cart turned out to be an asura. He had destroyed with just a kick. So yena anaha dvastam, yena shakataha shakatam dvastam or shakata asuraha dvastaha vadakritaha. Abhavena yena, who does not janma rahitaha, paramatma swarupaha saha paravasudevaha saha yena pura समुद्रमथनसमये बलिजित् कायः स्त्रीकृतः, हि हेड् यूस्ड् हिस् बाडि टु आर् हि हेड् टेकन् दि अवतारम् आफ् मोहिनी. बलिजित् कायः मीन्स् ऐ थिङ्क् बलि नामक युनो वामनावतारम्, वन् हू हेड् आल्सो टेकन् वामनावतार लेटर् इन् द फ्यूचर्. First, he took the form of a stri, which is Mohini avatara. It is an Amshavatara. It is not one of the Dashavataram, but it is called an Amshavatara, Mohini avatara. So, Balijit Kayaha, yaha, the one who had also taken the form, Kayaha, which had conquered Bali, Asura, he had first, Pura, before, during the Samudra Mathanam, he had taken the form of a stri, which is Mohini avatara. Okay? Yaha cha, उद्वृत्त भुजङ्ग ह हन्त हन्ति इति ह. सो भुजङ्गस्य हन्त उद्वृत्तः गर्वयुक्तः भुजङ्गस्य हन्त कालिङ्गः. सो हि वाज् द डेस्ट्रायर् आफ् कालिय द स्नेक् विच् वाज् वेरि एरगेण्ट्. यः च उद्वृत्त भुजङ्गः रव लयः, रवः इति शब्दः, so sound, any sound, he is the layasthanam for all sounds, that is every sound, any sound cannot go and reach him, even if we try to describe him, he is vacham agocharah, he is beyond any description. So yatra sarva shabdanam layah bhavati tadrisha vacham agochara swarupah paramatma vishnuh. Yah agam गां च अधारयत्. इन् टु अवतारस्, वन् इन् कृष्ण अवतार, अगः न गच्छति इति अगः, हि बोर् द गोवर्धन मौण्टन् आन् हिस् लिटिल् फिङ्गर्, एण्ड् गां पृथिवीं च यः अधारयत् इन् वराहमूर्ति अवतारं, हि बोर् द अर्थ् बिट्वीन् हिस् हाण्ड्स्, रैट्? सो यः टीतात् आमा. सो यः अगं गां च अधारयत्. सो गङ्गाम् इस् स्प्लिट् इन् टु रवो रवलयो अगं गां च यो अधारयत्. दिस् इस् भङ्गश्लेष एण्ड् अभङ्गश्लेष, एन् एक्साम्पल् आफ् बोत् इस् हियर्. सो यश्च उद्धृत्त भुजङ्गः रवलयः अगं गां च यः अधारयत्. देट् इस् हौ यु स्प्लिट् द सेकेण्ड् लैन्. द थर्ड् लैन्, यस्य अमराः यस्य शशिमच्छिरोहरः इति स्तुत्यं नाम आहुः. सो शशिमच्छिरोहर इस् वन् वर्ड् हियर्. शशिमत् शिरः, शशिनं मथ्नाति इति शशिमत्. राहुः, वन् हु डेस्ट्राय्स् द चन्द्र, हि गोबल्स् द मून् अप्, रैट्? दट् इस् वाट् वी थिङ्क् आफ् एस् ग्रहणम्. सो राहु हु डेस्ट्राय्स् द मून्, सः शशिमत्, तस्य शिरः हरति. सो राहु वास् वन् असुर हू वास् स्प्लिट् इन् टु टु बै विष्णु ड्यूरिङ्ग् मोहिनी अवतारम्, एण्ड् वेन् हि टुक् द सुदर्शन चक्र एण्ड् स्प्लिट् हिम् बिकास् हि हेड् द अमृतम्. सो यस्य यः राहोः शिरः हरति तादृशः इति अमराः स्तुवन्ति यम्, तादृशं विष्णुं सः विष्णुः पायात्. Okay, so the next line is Shashimachiro Haraha Iti Yasya Nama Amaraha Yasya Stutyam Nama Ahuhu. Those devas praise him as a person who had removed the head of Rahu. Stutyam means prashasyam, popular name. He is praised as one who removed the head of Rahu. Saha Andhaka Kshaya Karaha Andhakaha यादवाः. सो यादवानां क्षय गृहं, गृहं निवासस्थानं, द्वारक निर्माता. वेन् देर् प्रेसेन्स् वास् थ्रेटेण्ड्, कृष्ण पुल्ड् अ पार्ट् आफ् द ओशन् फ्रम् द लेण्ड् फ्रम् दि ओशन् एण्ड् हि कन्स्ट्रक्टेड् द्वारका फार् दि यादवास्. सो यादवानां निवासस्थाननिर्माता यः सः माधवः सर्वदः सर्वं ददाति सः त्वां पायात् लेट् हिम् प्रोटेक्ट् हिम्. दिस् इस् द टफर् वन् सो ऐ अटाक् दिस् फस्ट्. ईजियर् वन् इस् शिव. इट् विल् वेरि ब्यूटिफुलि फिट इन फॉर शिव. सो येन ध्वस्त मनोभवेन मनोभवः येन ध्वस्तः नाशित मन्मथः. सो वन हु डिस्ट्रॉयड मन्मथ येन पुरा बलिचित्कायः अस्त्रीकृतः अस्त्र इव बाणरूपतां प्रापितः. सो वन हु यूज्ड विष्णुस् शरीरं एंड सो नारायण बिकेम एन अस्त्रम एंड यूजिंग दट अस्त्र शिव डिस्ट्रॉयड द त्रिपुरम. सो त्रिपुर दहन काले पुरा नारायणम् अस्त्रं कृत्वा शिवः त्रिपुरम् अदहत्. यः च उद्वृत्तभुजङ्गहारवलयः. वि डोण्ट् नीड् टु ब्रेक् द वर्ड्स् एट् आल् फोर् दिस्. सो उद्वृत्तभुजङ्ग जस्ट् द फ्याक्ट् दट् द स्नेक् इस् आन् शिवस् नेक् इट् सेल्फ् विल् मेक् इट् वेरि एरगेण्ट् रैट्. सो उद्वृत्तभुजङ्गः एव हारः वलयः च. सो हिस् आभरणं आल् हिस् आर्नमेण्ट्स् आर् ओन्ली भुजङ्गम् वेरि एरगेण्ट् एण्ड् गर्व गर्वयुक्त भुजङ्गाः एव तस्य आभूषणानि. यश्च उद्वृत्तभुजङ्गहारवलयः गङ्गां च यः अधारयत् वन् हु हेस् गङ्गा आन् हिस् हेड् सिम्पल्. अमराः यस्य शशिमत् शिरः हरः इति स्तुत्यं नाम आहुः. शशिमत् शिरः चन्द्रचूडः यस्य शिरसि चन्द्रः वर्तते. सो शशिमत् शिरः यस्य शिरः शशिमान् अस्ति. वन् हु हेस् द मून् तादृशः हरः. हरः वन् हु डिस्ट्रोय्स् आल् द माया. हरति इति हरः मायां हरति. वन् हु रिमूव्स् दि अज्ञानम् एण्ड् इस् आफ् द फार्म् आफ् ज्ञानम्. यः ज्ञानस्वरूपः अस्ति तादृशः हरः इति अमराः स्तुवन्ति. स्तुत्यं नाम यस्य आहुः सः अन्धकक्षयकरः. अन्धक वन् हु डेस्ट्रायिड् दि असुर अन्धक अन्धक अरिः अन्धकरिपुः सः उमाधवः सर्वदा उमाधवः सर्वदा त्वां पायात्. उमायाः धवः पार्वत्याः पतिः सः त्वां पायात्. लेट् हिम् प्रोटेक्ट्. नौ हियर् देर् इस् नो काण्टेक्स्ट् फोर् अस्. Let's say this is just a prathama shloka, the first mangala shlokam of a poet. So it can you be used as both, actually both Shiva and Vishnu are being praised in the shloka. So both since we don't have abhida niyamaka abhavat, what it means is we don't have the context to fix that this is only Shiva is being praised. And Vishnu, the meaning of Vishnu is suggested here, and so there is Shabda Shakti. We cannot say that here. Hence, both meanings are Vachyam. They are primary meaning. So it is Slesha and not Dhvani. Okay. The context, see, because it is Tvam Payat, and Tvam Payat gives us, does not give us any context here. If we did said sarvado madavaha sarvada umadavaha, I don't know how it could be where you can fix the context and then there is a maybe if it is telling the exploits of Shiva illaya achulle
so inda madina enoda kelvi appo somehow epdiyo context and Shivan ne fix pandrom na innor vali yen kekalan appo maybe solra but Shivan ne fix pannitona the விஷ்ணு பரமா இருக்கிற அர்த்தம் வந்து இட்ஸ் கைண்ட் ஆஃப் என்ன சொல்ற ரொம்ப இட் இன்வால்வ்ஸ் டூ மச் ஆஃப் த இன்டெலக்ட் அப்படியே இது பண்றது இந்த சகிருதயத்துவம் போய் ஸோ விஷ்ணுன்னு கான்டெக்ட் இருந்து சிவன் அர்த்தம் வந்தாலாவது எனக்கு துவனி ஒரு மாதிரி புரியா இருக்கு அந்த இடத்துல மேபி வி குட் ஆர் யூ சப்த சக்தி இந்த பக்கம் வந்து கண்டிப்பா சொல்ல முடியாது.
ஆமா, இட்ஸ் பிகாஸ் தி அப்பரண்ட் மீனிங் அண்ட் தி வே தி ஸ்லோகா இஸ் அரேஞ்ச்ட் இஸ் சோ பியூட்டிஃபுல்லி கனெக்டட் வித் சிவா. Anna, he has praised Vishnu with the same fervor. He has praised Brahma also with the same fervor. அதனால வி கெனாட் ஃபிக்ஸ் த கான்டெக்ஸ்ட் ஃபார் ஹிம் அண்ட் சே தட் இட் இஸ் ஒன்லி சிவா ஆர் ஒன்லி விஷ்ணு. அப்போ ரெண்டு அர்த்தமுமே அபிதா நியாமகசிய அபாவாத் தத்ர ஸ்லேஷஹா ஏவ ந துத்வனி. சரியா? அதனால திஸ் இஸ் அன் எக்ஸாம்பிள் ஆஃப் ஸ்லேஷா.
இல்ல இஃப் இட்ஸ் அந்த மாதிரி ஒரு காவியம் லைக் சிவன் ஹரிஹர அபேதம் சம்திங் லைக் தட் ஒரு தர் 100 ஷ்லோகம்
ஹரிஹர அபேதம்
லைக் தட் அந்த ராகவ யாதவியமா அந்த மாதிரி ஒரு இது வேர் ரெண்டு பேர் ஈச் ஸ்லோகம் வந்து ரெண்டு பேரையும் போட்றதுன்ற மாதிரி
தென் இட் இஸ் ஸ்லேஷ ஒன்லி.
அப்படி இருந்தா கண்டிப்பா ஸ்லேஷ தான்.
இஃப் இட் இஸ் சம்திங் லைக் ராகவ யாதவியம் கண்டிப்பா அந்த இது இருக்கே அது யாரு புஷ் புஷ் Pushpa, Pushpadantiya, one poet has written a shlokam where both Shiva and it'll address to both Shiva and Vishnu. For a set of shlokas kuduthirkar. Adhik Madhusudana Saraswati has written a vyakhyanam also.
Oh.
Forget that. First few shlokas will be on both Shiva and Vishnu. Yamolla. Okay. Thank you. ஆக்ஷிப்த இது பதசிய விவரணம். சோ வாட் இட் மீன்ஸ் இஸ் ஆக்ஷிப்த ஏவ அலங்காரஹா சப்தசக்தியா பிரகாசதே. சோ வை ஹி ஸ்டார்ட்ஸ் ஆஃப் வித் திஸ் இஸ் லெட்ஸ் ஜஸ்ட் லுக் அட் த காரிகா விருத்தி தேர். நனு அலங்காராந்தர பிரதிபாயாம் அபி ஸ்லேஷ வியபதேசஹ பவதி இதி தர்சிதம் பட்ட உத்பட்டேன தத் புனரபி சப்தசக்தி மூலஹ த்வனிஹி நிரவகாசஹ இதி ஆசங்க்ய இதமுக்தம் ஆக்ஷிப்தஹ. Purvapakshi has started, the context is Purvapakshi has started saying that if you say every sthalam where arthantaram akshipyate is or arthantaram prakashate, every sthalam of that is only shabda shakti, then there is no scope for slesha. So there is a scope for slesha where both are vachyam. He gave an example for that. Now, Bhatta Udbhata, Anandavardhana wants to argue and say that when an alankara is akshipta or it is suggested vyangena pratiyate chet, there it is only shabda shakti, because otherwise if we take it like how Bhatta Udbhata has said, then there will be no scope for shabda shakti udbhava at all. So what is Bhatta Udbhata's point? He says alankarantara pratibhayam அபி ஸ்லேஷ வியபதேசா பவதி. He does not accept, see, his stance is there can be the alankara, arthalankaras can exist without slesha, but slesha can never exist without other alankaras. So when upama or rupakam comes with slesha alankara, I only want to denote it as slesha. I do not want to say it as slishta rupakam, slishta apannuti, slishta vyatirekam. I am not going to include the arthalankaras. That is Bhatta Udbhata's stance. Okay. Alankarantara pratibhayam api. Even if there is an indication of another alankara like upama or vyatireka or virodha, I still will consider only slesha if there are words which have double meaning. Because the scope of slesha is very little. It always comes with, mostly 99% it comes with another alankara. Like even here we can say Shiva and Vishnu are equal. They are both one is equal to the other is similar to the other, so there can be an upama there also. So slesha can never exist alone. So whatever alankara it may come along with, I will only denote it as slesha. That is Bhatta Udbhata's point. Then there will be no scope for shabda shakti, because even when you have a great upama alankara dhvani from a vastu, we call it as shabda shakti udbhava dhvani in Anandavardhana's realm, right? So in dhvanika, the dhvanikara says that it is only vastuna alankara dhvani. Then every vastuna alankara dhvani has to be set as slesha according to Bhatta Udbhata, because Bhatta Udbhata also Udbhata does not accept dhvani at all. He is an alankaravadi, he is not a dhvanikara, not a dhvanivadi, right? So tatpunarapi shabda shakti moolaha dhvanihi niravakashaha, there is no space for shabda shakti udbhava at all iti ashankya. that someone might come up with such a question. For that, Anandavardhana has given the word akshiptaha or suggested. Now he is going to give the difference between vachya alankara and akshipta alankara. He will first give several examples of where there is slesha. There is also another alankara along with slesha, which is vachyam, which has been expressed by the words in the shloka itself. So tadayam artaha. So what is the meaning of this akshipta? Yatra shabda shaktya sakshat alankarantaram vachyam. Underline that. Yatra shabda shaktya, by the force of words, another alankara is expressed in the shloka itself. Sakshat, directly it has been expressed. Sat pratibhasate saha sarvaha slesha vishayaha. That is the scope of slesha. That is the domain of slesha. Yatra tu shabda shaktya samarthya akshiptam. Samarthya akshiptam means it is suggested. Vachya vyatiriktam. It does not depend on the vachyartha at all. The vachyartha may have double meaning. You confine the meaning of the vachyartham to one. There are several examples actually in Shishupalavadam where there is a description of the Raivataka Parvatam. As he is describing the Parvata in the fourth shloka or the fifth shloka or something like that, it is only the description of the Parvatam. But the words have double meaning, and the meaning of Shiva comes to our mind as if he is describing Shiva. That is where that is dhvani for us. So Shabda Shaktya, by the power of the words, which where the primary meaning has been fixed because of context, because of samyogo viprayogascha, it is there in Kavya Prakasham. If you read it, you'll know. So there are many determining factors to fix the context of the meaning of to fix the vachyartham, the primary meaning. So after you have fixed the vachyartham, then if there is another meaning suggested, vyangyameva alankarantaram prakashate, if another alankara is seen through vyangya or suggested, sahadvanehe vishayaha. Okay, this is very clear. Shabda shaktya sakshat alankarantara pratibha yata. When there is another alankara which is vachyam, so he is going to give virodhabhasa, and then I think it is vyatireka alankaram, adukapram rupakam. Yeah, rupakam. Then vakrokti. Four or five alankaras he is going to give. Then he will give the other dhvani vishayaha. Then he will give examples for shabda shakti uttavaha. So the first one here is virodhabhasa alankara. So tasya vina biharena nisarga deva harinau janayamasa tukkasya vismayam na payodharau. Atra shringara vibhachari vismayakhyaha bhavaha sakshat virodha alankarascha pratibhasate iti virodhachaya anugrahinaha sleshasya ayam vishayaha natu anuswana upamabhyangyasya dhvanehe. This is not an example of dhvani. It is an example of slesha along with virodhabhasa alankara. There is another alankara, but you cannot just ignore that virodhabhasa alankara and just look at slesha. We need that virodhabhasa, and it is a slesha. There is no dhvani here. The meaning of the shloka is tasyaha payodharau harena vina api nisarga deva harinau. Hara, the word harinau, hari means haraha asya asti iti hari athava manohari ityapi arthadvayam. So tasyaha payodharau, her stana, her payodhara, her breasts are vinapi harena, without any necklace. It is looking very beautiful. Nisarga deva, naturally it is looking beautiful. It doesn't need another extra embellishment like a necklace or muktaharam. So without a haram, it is hari. That is it. So here the meaning, kasya vismayam na janayatuhu. Who will not be surprised by looking at such a beauty in front of them? Which is naturally beautiful even without a necklace. Okay. The சமத்காரம் ஹியர் இந்த ஸ்லோகம் இஸ் ஹாரேண வினா அபி ஈவன் விதவுட் ஹார இட் இஸ் ஹாரி ஹாரி மீன்ஸ் ஹாரவந்தௌ இட் ஹேஸ் அ ஹாரம் ஈவன் விதவுட் ஹேவிங் ஹார தட் இஸ் த அப்பேரண்ட் மீனிங் தட் இஸ் தேர் விச் சீம்ஸ் லைக் தேர் இஸ் அ விரோதம் So the definition of virodhabhasa is abhasatve virodhasya virodhabhasa. So when there is an apparent virodha or a contradiction between two words or contradiction in the meaning, but it is only apparent and you can remove the apparent contradiction by giving a different meaning. Where there is one word has two meanings, which is again slesha. Because of that slesha, the virodha is parihriyate. You remove that virodha, there is no virodha once you understand the second meaning. So you say it is beautiful. So hari also means with the hara, with the necklace. Even without a necklace, her payodharav are with necklace. That is a virodham, that is a contradiction here. So to remove that contradiction, virodha pariharartham, we take the second meaning and that meaning is manoharav. It is attractive. So even without a necklace, it is attractive. Because of the word api, vina api, the virodhabhasa is clearly expressed here. The alankara is not suggested. Harena vina harena probably might have been just an akshiptam. I'm not sure how this could have become a shabdashakti mooladhvani, but we just take it as it is not, and there is no dhvani here, but there are other sthalam where there is dhvani. He is going to give that later. So here that api shabda, even without even though there is no hara, it is hari. That api shabdaha eva virodham darshayati. And then because of that, you are expecting, how can something without a necklace have a necklace? Then that contradiction has to be explained somehow. And there is an expectation of the second meaning. Without the second meaning, we cannot understand the vachyartham. It is not purnam, sampurnam. So we need the second meaning. We need the artham of manoharam. Only when that artham is also present, the vachyartham is complete. Whereas in dhvani, we have seen vachyartha stands independent of the dhvani, or dhvani is based on the vachyartham, but it can stand independent. Correct? So vachyartham is complete here. It should be complete in the case of dhvani. But here in the shlokam, the vachyartham itself is not complete. Atra shringara vyabhichari vismayakhyaha bhavaha, the vismaya bhava. There is no bhavadvani also here. Kasya vismayam na janayamasatuhu. Who will not be surprised by looking at such bosoms? But that vismaya is also expressed in the shloka itself. Sakshat atra asti virodabhasa alankaraha apishabdena sakshat bhasate. That is also expressed here primarily. Iti virodha chaya anugrahinaha sleshaha. Anugrahinaha sleshasya ayam vishayaha. So it is the slesha alankara helps the virodhabhasam. Right? Virodha chaya anugrahi. It helps the virodha. Hence this is an example of slesha along with virodhabhasa, where that virodhabhasa alankara is vachyam or expressed primarily and it is not dhvani. So natu anuswana upama vyangyasya dvanihi. There is no upamanam here, right? You can't say an upama alankara dvani is here, nor is that virodhabhasa alankara dvani. Easy to understand. Next is alanka alakshyakrama vyangyasya tu dvanehe vachyena sleshena virodhena va vyanjitasya vishayaha eva. This has nothing to do with slesha or anything. He just keeps reiterating by saying that if you have to look at alakshakrama vyangyam means can be, na, he said shringara vyabhichari vismayakhyaha bhavaha. That is, then it is a bhavadvani, right? No, this is alakshakrama vyangyaha, that bhavadvani வாச்சியேன ஸ்லேஷேன விரோதேனவா வியஞ்சிதஸ்ய விஷயஹ ஏவ. ஓன்லி இஃப் இஃப் த வாச்சியார்த்த ஆர் த ஸ்லேஷ ஆர் த விரோத கிவ்ஸ் ரைஸ் டு தட் விஸ்மயம் ஆஸ் அ சஜஷன், தென் ஓன்லி யூ கேன் சே இட் இஸ் அ பாவத்வனி, இட் இஸ் நாட் பாவத்வனி ஹியர். அலக்ஷியக்ரம வியங்கியஸ்ய த்வனேஹே விஷய ததா ஏவ பவதி யத்ர வாச்சியேன ஆக்ஷிப்தா பவதி பாவஹ, நது சாக்ஷாத் ஸ்லோகே உக்தஹ. ஓகே, யதா மமைவ ஆக்சுவலி இஸ் அ கனெக்ஷன் டு தி ஏர்லியர் டெக்ஸ்ட் வேர் ஹி சேஸ் சப்தசக்தியா சாக்ஷாத் அலங்காராந்தர பிரதிபா. சொல்லுமா?
சோ சாரி, ஜஸ்ட் எனக்கு சட்டுன்னு ஒரு கன்ஃபியூஸ் ஆயிடுச்சு. சோ இந்த சப்த சக்தியினால அவர் வந்து ஆனந்தவர்தனா வந்து சப்தசக்தியா வஸ்து துவனிகி தான் ஒத்துக்கிறது இல்ல, பட் அலங்கார துவனி அண்ட் ரச ரசபாவ இத்தியாதி அந்த துவனிய
ஒத்துக்கிறார். ரசத்வனிங்கிறச்சு உனக்கு இட் பிகம்ஸ் அசம்லக்ஷிகரம துவனி, ரைட்? இட் இஸ் நாட் சம்லக்ஷிகரம துவனி, இட் இஸ் நாட் சப்தசக்தி உத்பவா ரசத்வனிகி இல்லையே. சப்தசக்தி உத்பவா ultimately we can look at that rasadvani, but there will be a point where it is asamlakshikramam, that is only rasadvani. So you cannot have that in samlakshikrama.
Okay, appo inda edathile yen avar andha bhavadvani point eduthunaru puriyala
alakshikrama vage. Someone might point out that there is dvani here where there is a visnaya bhavadvani. Appo he says, no, no, it is sakshat kriyate. See the earlier sentence.
Swapada vachyam arukku.
Swapada vachyam. Vismayam kasya vismayam na janayam asatu. Who will not be surprised by this? Appadi nana, the surprise has been said here. I am not getting surprised because of the shloka. Yeah.
Yes. Okay, chumma or just or point a solitu pay.
That's all. He just wants to reiterate that point in the middle. Suppose someone raises the point that, you know, it can be a bhavadvani, why are you not mentioning it? Because it is this particular shloka that he has taken and there is a vismayam there.
Okay,
so this has no relevance to the present argument, but it has relevance only to the present shloka. அதனால அலக்ஷக்ரம வியங்கியஸ்ய து த்வனேஹே வாச்யேன ஸ்லேஷேன விரோதேன வா வ்யஞ்சிதஸ்ய விஷயஹ ஏவ. So only if it is வியஞ்சிதா ஆர் வியங்கா, அதாவது என்ன சஜஸ்டட். ஓகே, நவ் திஸ் யதா மமைவ ஆக்சுவலி கனெக்ட்ஸ் வித் தி ஏர்லியர் வேர் வாச்சியதா அலங்காராந்தர பிரதிபா எத்திர வாச்சியத்வேன உக்தா. பிரதிபா எத்திர வாச்சியத்வேன உக்தா ஸ்லாக்யாசேஷதனும். திஸ் இஸ் ஐ திங்க் ஆனந்தவர்தனா ஸ்லோக இட்ஸ். விஷமபாண லீலாவா? I don't know where this shloka is. Shlagya Asheshatanum Sudarshana Karaha Sarvanga Leelajita Trailokyam Charanaravinda Lalitena Akranta Loko Harihi Vibhranam Mukham Indurupam Akhilam Chandratma Chakshuhu Dadhat Sthaneyam Swatanoho Apashyat Adhikam Sarukmini Vo Avatat. Sarukmini Vaha Avatat. Let that Rukmini protect you. Vaha Yushmanu Rakshatu. Let Rukmini protect you. So how is that Rukmini? Rukmini is being seen by Vishnu as beyond or as someone who is superior to his own Sharira. Swatanoho Adhikam Sthane Yam Harihi Apashyat. Sa Rukmini Vaha Avatat. The one, that Rukmini who was seen by Hari, Harihi Yam Apashyat, Hari saw that Rukmini as Swatanoho Api Adhikam Iti Yam Apashyat. Adhikam Sthane Apashyat. Sthane means very appropriately, correctly, Sariyapathar. Where am I saying? Sthane means not position. He saw her as someone who is superior to himself. Very truly he saw her as superior to himself. And he gives the reasons for that. So one is all the Prathama Vibhakti should connect to Harihi. Dvitiya Vibhakti will connect to Yam, which is Rukminim. So let's look at Rukminim first. Shlagya Ashesha Tanu. She's got a very beautiful and praiseworthy shariram, angam, yasyaha asheshatanu. Her entire body is shlakhyam, whereas Hari is Sudarshana Karaha. He only has his hand, which is beautiful to look at. I prefer to go with this. I've just given the Anvayam below. If we go through the Anvayam, then the beauty of the whole shlokam is lost. You have to go follow the shloka pattern to understand the beauty of the shloka. So Shlaghyasheshatanum, on one hand, Rukmini, her entire body is beautiful and praiseworthy, whereas Vishnu, Sudarshana Karaha, Sudarshanam Kare Asti. He has that chakram in his hand, but the more other meaning, the Shlesha that contributes to that contrast, that Vyatirekam is Sudarshana Karaha. He has only his hand is very beautiful to look at, not his entire body. Next is on one hand, Sarvanga Leela Jita Trailokyam. Her entire body has one Leela. She has a Sarva Anga Leela Leelaya Jita Trailokyam. She is won over the entire world by her beautiful, the graceful actions that are there in her body. Sarvanga Leelaya Jita Trailokyam. She is won over all three worlds. Whereas here, Charana Aravinda Lalitena Akranta Lokaha Harihi. You can say he is with one only during Vamanavataram, with his leg, he conquered the world. How that is better, I don't know. I think this is better. The Charanaravindam seems better here, but let's take it as Sarvanga Leela Jita Trailokyam. She, with all her beauty, she won over, that is, she is the most beautiful person in the three worlds. Whereas she, Vishnu here, during Vamanavataram, only with his leg he had measured the worlds and he had conquered the worlds. Akranta Loka. Charanaravindasya Lalitam Tribhuvana Akramana Kridam. Actually, it is more Vishnu who is more Adhikam here. Interesting. None of the Vyakhyata has explained that. I don't know. Okay. So Charanaravinda Lalitena, by a very in a very playful manner, with just one of his feet, Vishnu had conquered the worlds. Bibranam Mukham Indurupam Akhilam. Akhilam Mukham Indurupam Akhilam Mukham Bibranam. She has her entire face is looking like the Chandra, the moon. She's looking so beautiful like the moon, whereas for Hari, Chandratma Chakshuhu Eva Dadat, only one of his eye is the moon. Surya and Chandra, one eye is Surya, the other eye is Chandra. So only one eye is Chandra, whereas for her, the entire face is beautiful like the moon. So the contrast here. So Harihi Yam Rukmini Svatanoho Api Adhikam Apashyate Sthane Apashyate. He very correctly saw her as someone who has exceeded himself in beauty. Sa Rukmini Tadrishi Rukmini Vaha Avatat Yushman Rakshatu. Here the Vyatireka Alankaram is also mentioned with the word Adhika. So Sudarshana has two meanings. One is Sushtu Darshanam. Sudarshana, Sudarshanam chata, Sudarshanaha Karaha Yasya Saha. So one who has a beautiful hand, which is beautiful to look at, or one who has Sudarshana Chakram in his hand. So that Shlesha also is expressed here. So Shlesha is never, so both meanings we need, right? Only with that Shlesha helps us understand how Bhagavad-apekshaya Rukmini Adhika Asti iti avagamanartham Shlesha Avashyakaha. Vyatireka is also expressed here by the word Adhikam. If that Adhikam is not mentioned, then probably it is Vyatireka Dhvani. Then you can have Shabda Shakti Udbhava Dhvani. Because that just imagine a shlokam where that sthane yam svatanoho avashyat adhikam, that portion is not mentioned. Instead of that, there is another visheshanam for both Hari and Rukmini, which expresses that difference as a suggestion, then that will be a vyatireka dhvani. Whereas here, because he has mentioned it as swatanoho api adhikam, then atra vachyataya eva vyatireka chaya anugrahi slesha. This slesha helps to highlight that vyatireka. Vyatireka is where there is a difference between two objects are shown in the shloka. That is a vyatireka alankara. The next one is I think we'll deal with that next class. We'll stop with this. Okay. The connection for yatha mamaiva is shabda shaktya sakshat alankarantara pratibha yatha abdingarche, it is virodabhasa. So yatha mamaiva is again, it is a nato anuswana upamavyangyasya dvanehe irukkalliya.
Adoda yatha. Okay.
Adoda connect pannikano. That is why I said this line, alakshikrama vyangyasya tu dvanehe vachyena, is a connection for tasya vinapi harena. This yatha mamaiva has to be connected with the previous line of nato anuswana upamavyangyasya dvanehe. Yatha mamaiva. There is another example from my own shloka, which is actually vyatireka, an example of vyatireka and shlesha.
And sorry, no, the shabda shaktiyan avar solracha adu vandu abida shaktiya.
Abida shakti, yes. Yes. Okay. Yes.
Just, I just want to make sure
clear it is na. Not shabda shakti utbavaha.
Yes, shabda yes, adu puriyan. Ah.
Shabda shaktiya na abida shakti da.
Okay, okay. Thanks.
No problem.